Welcome to Magic Gathering Strat. I'm Dan, and I'm about to play the first round of this draft. And I'm quite nervous, because I know that my limited review had a lot of viewers. It's one of the most successful videos on the YouTube channel, on this YouTube channel, in the last month. And I know people will be watching this draft quite a lot, but if these are the kinds of deck you get in Modern Masters draft, I think this looks extremely strong, and I wouldn't play two pieces unless I listen to Brian Wong. But maybe two is excessive, is it? Is it excessive? Is it better to play Binding Beam? Stinkweed Imp, it must be better. God, okay, what am I bringing in? Maybe it is the Stinkweed Imp. For removal, for reusable removal, and then just defeating everybody with my... It's gotta be the Stinkweed Imp. Okay, and another creature, that must be good. So, last second change. Not too sure about it, but the Stinkweed Imp... My deck is rather defensive. We will try to win in the air with the 3, 4, 5, 6 flyers. And then rule the ground with all the rebels and the trapper. So, what we do with the rebel searchers is to bring in the first thing we search for at the end of his turn is another rebel searcher if he kills the first one. Blightspeaker can take one, and that guy can also take one. Wow, Amro Scout feels a lot better than Blightspeaker, but Blightspeaker has got the reach. Am I stupid when I cut one of the Blightspeakers? And Una will just be insane. So I have 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 rebels. So I cut plenty of rebels. What about Sense Enlistment? How good is it? Okay, it's worth with the Cloud Ghost Ranger. Maybe I'm stupid not to play the other. Pilfers will get back any creature, including then Ona. My strong removal then is Stinkweed Imp, that can get anything. Stinkweed Imp, Capsule, and Patoosh. Sanctum, the first Sanctum Gargle gets back the Capsule or Bone Splitter. Bone Splitter makes my flyers huge. This looks like a super good limited deck. And I would love to sweep this tournament. That would be incredibly fun. Nebiath. I lost the die roll. Haven't got a searcher, but I think I have plenty. I'm not sure about the Deep Cavern Imp at all. Maybe I should cut it for another searcher. Homunculus! And I might really suffer here if I don't draw another land. I can be fairly sure he plays an artifact, and he's probably blue-white, yes. Stinger doesn't do a lot. There's the land I was looking for. So what do I really play next turn? It's probably the Stinkweed Imp. Or is it? think it is. And I need to draw more mana. Does Ona not tap? Can't be blocked. Sounds pretty good. But I'm gonna try to stop the bleeding here. He only has three cards in hand, so I don't think he can stop me. Fair trickery. Then I'm down to 12. Oh, what did he do? Did he misplay that? I think he misplayed it. That's super sweet if people play double dollar drafts and then do horrible misplays. Did he fake the counterspell? What happened there? Okay, maybe this guy isn't John Finkel. Will he miss his fourth land drop? I'm blocking the homunculus. Any time of day. The rebel. But he's not an artifact. So he can't take the stingers counters. So we really need to kill the homunculus. Which we'll happily will do. And we're absolutely not gonna dredge him because we want mana. We're not drawing the card. Do we want the Fairy Macabre? Do we want the Deep Cavern Imp? What will we discard to the Deep Cavern Imp? The Seeker, Changeling, Macabre. I am playing the Deep Cavern Imp, maybe forcing him to halt. Not too sure about that. Not too sure what I do if he doesn't attack. I should plan this better. Maybe he's just a fog for a turn. But I'm so much ahead now that in cards that I could really take the loss of a card here. But it's better to have a 2/2 creature in play without paying mana than... I think I'm gonna discard the Fairy Macabre if he doesn't let me trade, but he is letting me trade here. Do I kill the Stinger? No, I'm gonna trade. Maybe he has a trick, but then he'll be down to 2 cards, so that's okay. 2 minutes ahead on the clock, feeling good about that. Here's a trick, Test of Faith. Oh, pretty good card. And let's make a note of that. Test of Faith. Whoa, and now I'm starting to fade here. Is another artifact card is dead, yes. So now it's very critical that I miss when he doesn't miss. Wait a minute, oh, I could have used it. Oh, God, I could have used it against the Mirror Retriever. But I'm not gonna block here, I'm gonna have to double block the Changeling. And without the Changeling, he doesn't really have a lot going on. So I think I'm gonna block the Stinger. Let it die. And then next turn I'm gonna double block the changeling. I should have gone 18 lands. And actually getting the Stink Within back here isn't too bad. But I can get him back with the Pilferer next turn if I draw something. Now I'm going for the double block. And he has just one card left. So it might just work. And then of course if I get to play Una, I might just outvalue him totally. So let's hope he doesn't have a trick here. Because in that case we are pretty much toast. Going to 6. I don't want to lose this game. Hell, I don't want to lose this game. Please don't play a bomb now. No, it doesn't play anything. Not going for the Stinkweed Imp. The Scout is pretty broken here actually. And next turn I can bring in Rebels. But what Rebels? Is there anybody else that is good to play here? No, I just have to survive until I get another mana. And maybe I'm just gonna block here. And he can get back something. I'm just gonna block and I'm gonna do that with the Seekers. Because it's not like I have to get stuff to play. Okay, that's his last card. So all I need is draw land, get the Pilferers, get back the Stinkweed Imp, and then play Una and win. Oh, it's the counterspell for a lot of mana and remove cards. Logic not. Why did he remove the cards when he didn't have to? And that's okay with me. And I hope he doesn't draw business here, and I hope I draw the land, and then we're off. God, my deck feels so much better than his does. But I am not the one with 20 life. Oh yes. Is it a Stinkweed Imp? I think it is. Or maybe it's the Changeling. Or the Macabre. It's the Macabre, of course. So I can destroy the Enforcer effect, eller the Retriever effect. Okay. And what is he getting back? He's getting back something, but I can remove the two target cards. Does Ona not tap? Echo in Truth on the Pilfer, is that really the way to win the game? Maybe it is. He only needs to hit one more time. And if I can now, I'm gonna play two blockers here actually. So I'm really sure that I'm not losing. Yeah, okay. So I'm dragging down the Mirror Retriever. Then his effect goes on the stack. And he has to target something. And then I use the Fairy Macabre. And then I play the Emerald Scout. He took the stinger. So I'm getting the stinger and the retriever. And the effect fizzles. And I play the Amro Scout. And then I'm gonna play Pilfer again. For the... probably the Stinkweed Imp. I always say the Stinkweed Imp, but I never get him. Maybe it's the Seekers. Therion Sculptor, he is not the best guy in the world. See? I would love to play Una now. But this guy isn't gonna kill me by himself. So I'm gonna swing, play Pilferers. He can kill me. But I don't really care. I can get back the Amro Scout actually if he kills me. So let's go for that. Okay, he didn't, so I'm getting back. I think the Fairy Macabre is the strong choice. But maybe it is the Stinkweed Imp this time, really. So I'm done. And I don't need to rush this because I'm 3 minutes ahead of him. And I'm gonna play Una. Hello, says Ona. And I'm still gonna swing with the rebel here. And he only has one power, so I'm swinging with the pilfers too. Speeding up the clock. And then Ona's ability is just really crazy. Can I kill him this turn? I can do 12 damage. That's not enough. Okay, if I untap with Una in play, I feel pretty secure. She really doesn't tap. That's just crazy. Well, I'm not misunderstanding anything here, am I? Nice! Okay, Una was totally, totally insane. Blightspeaker, Pepper, Smoke, etc. Do I need that? No, I don't really think I do. I like my deck as is. I don't have any artifact removal really. Were there any good targets for the Petharsis? I'm sure there is some target for it. But do I really need it against him? Maybe I just need a Blightspeaker. Or an Absorb Viz. I don't know if that is good. It seems to be like the really bad affinity deck. But this time he might come rushing out the gates. I have the Blightspeaker. I have the mana for his search ability. I'm gonna keep this hand. And he gets the Homunculus draw again. That's gonna hurt. And if he kills this Blightspeaker, I will be in so much trouble. Don't kill my Blightspeaker! Pretty nice hand. And I'd be very tempted to kill the Mirror Retriever, so it can't get back the Homunculus. And also, of course he will probably not attack with it, but if he attacks, it will reduce the Homunculus. It will just do so much. So I'm blocking the Mirror Retriever here, if he attacks with both. But if he doesn't, I could just play the other one. How many effects are there in Modern Master that kills several X1 creatures? I am not sure. And what Rebel am I getting? I'm getting the Trapper. Now he needs to play another artifact, which he will of course be able to do, but... Whoa! Wow, what do I do against the Esper Sowa? What do I do against it? I have nothing I can do against it. I can die, but I can bring the Tapper! So I absolutely have to use my... Yeah, I have to bring out the Blightspeaker, get the Tapper. I will be taking 12 damage before that happens. But I have like a small possibility of survival. And the of course the Homunculus is not gonna do any damage to me, because he's gonna be bouncing. And of course I can always double block with two flyers. And there is another rebel flyer, the Imp, yes. So I need to start bringing, but this is the Trapper first that I'm gonna bring in. So maybe I can survive the Esper Sowa attack. And this deck doesn't fear flooding. Of course I have so many mana sinks. And if I have all my rebels in play, then I win. What if he kills the Blightspeaker? Then I'm in trouble, but I can't afford to wait for the Trapper. I have to get the Trapper this time. And it's at the end of his next turn. I'm getting the Trapper. He's really taking his sweet time. He needs to play the Homunculus again, so he's gonna play something that costs 3, which will not be fun. Oh! He doesn't play the Homunculus, he has another artifact. Maybe an Edder Spell Bomb. That would really suck. But he still has to return it. And he is not discarding artifacts, because he needs his artifacts. If this guy isn't all in on the Esper Sowa plan, then something is wrong. He must play an artifact here. Otherwise he just tapped horribly. And he doesn't play the artifact. What is this? So I get to search for the Trapper. And he must return the Esper Sowa. What is he doing? What? Okay, I should laugh. Sorry. But... very weird. But I'm really happy. Every match here is for 7 ticks. So I am really happy to win a match. If all my opponents are like this, I will not complain. It's Mr. Homunculus! And I'm gonna show you the power of the Rebel Chain. There is no Rebel Chain. There was a Rebel Chain in Mercadian Masks, but I never, when I drafted Mercadian Masks, I never got a deck like this one. This is much better than any Mercadian Mask deck I ever played. But I never played a good Rebels deck in Mercadian Masks. And Narcomoba, who is just a 1-1 flyer. And I can kill 1-1 flyers all day. Where is the Esper Soa? The Esper Soa is a fantastic card. Now I almost don't want to play the Trapper. But it is the Trapper. And next time I'm gonna bring in the Imp. And yeah. And let's test the Rebel Theory here. So I'm gonna tap the Homunculus if he is if he becomes a 2-2. Or maybe I'm gonna kill it actually. No, I'm not gonna kill it. What is going on? His hand is there's an Esper Soa in his hand. And that thing will be his last hope. But so I'm tapping you. Though I'm not sure why. And Narcomobas, I don't think they're playable at all. In limited. But this guy is starting to get very close to losing on time, and I hate that. Because that will make me stressed for saving the video. If I'm the last match, it takes about 2 minutes to get things done. But what is he doing? So there might be a video of match 1 and match 2 together. But that's a bit clumsy, isn't it? But I think that's what I'm gonna do. Okay. It targets me. Creature don't untap during target's play's next untap step. Okay. That's really interesting. So I tap that. And then you swing, perhaps. So I have to get myself a flyer. And who is my flyer? It's the bear. Where is he? Did I sideboard him out? Whoa, skillful. Okay, let's go through this. I did sideboard him out, right? And this is why you shouldn't do that. No, it's the Deep Cavern Imp. There you go. Side block. And there's the Ethereum Sculptor. Pay the Echo. And wow, I'm just ruling this world. So we can just start beating down, right? And his artifacts will be so valuable to him. So we are playing the Seekers. And the Changeling. Here's the Espeso. I'm gonna block the Homunculus with the Changeling to kill an artifact. Or with the Seeker. Well, he's just giving up here, isn't he? So I block like that and like that. Okay. Well, I can't attack here, so I'm gonna tap the... Cloud Goat Ranger. No, I'm gonna tap the Espesoa right before he is gonna attack. And then I can swing with everything next turn. I forgot to use the trap. Okay, I win, and there's time left. Great. Okay, I'm 1-0 in this draft, so at the worst it can be 1-2. That's fantastic. Thank you for watching Magic Gathering Strat. I'm Dan. I'm playing this first Modern Masters draft on the first day.